Hello and welcome to my channel. This is NECOLIB, Northeast Collaborative Librarianship. At the very beginning, I welcome all you to my channel and request you to subscribe my channel so that as and when the new videos will be uploaded in the channel, you will receive the updates. In NECOLIB is a concept where we are trying to bring all the library professional on a single platform, mostly for the northeastern part of India, and helping each other in terms of technology related issues. So today I will prepare a video on how to create authorized values in Koha and how to link them with your mark structure, so that as and when there is some specific field to be added to your records, you may take help of the authorized values and get a drop down list. So for that, first we will log into Koha. This is my Koha portal. We log into Koha. As I am a super user, first I will go to Koha administration. Click on Koha administration, scroll down and click on authorized values. Here these are the default authorized values. You will see there are 43 authorized values already there. B-SOT1, B-SOT2, CAN, C code. So we will start adding authorized values for our departments, like our subject. Like in that case, whatever the like, sometime you have to add the subject code in the particular item, particular book. You may put the subject code in the your what is called subject heading also, tropical term. That is separate format that is coming in the text, but in terms of you can put a subject or in the department. In the sometimes you can put in the name of the department also, how many books are available in that particular department, or how many books have been purchased by that particular department. So in now we will show the okay, we'll take a example as a department. So department here already a subject code is already there. Though in case of new category, you will just click on new category if you want new category, or you want to add in the existing category, click on that particular category. Whenever you click on particular category, you will find there are names of this category, what are the other authorized values are there in the category. This will be shown here. Here you will find no category is there. No category means only department, but in the department no value is already added. So we will start a new authorized value for the department. Like department is the heading, then we will put the authorized values. So first we will put the authorized value code. So let's take, we will start with physics. So the code is of your own. Okay, last I will give PHY. You have to do some homework, what code you will put, so that this code should not be repeating with other, any other codes that you have given any time. So PHY, or you can give PHYX. So the description, you write physics. This is the internal description, the staff interface, and you and copy paste in app. Then you can select the libraries. If you select all libraries, this authorized values will be applicable to all libraries. Then click on save. Now you will find that one authorized value has already been added here. So likewise, you can add another authorized value. For another authorized value, you click on the same new authorized value for department. Then next we will add chemistry. So we will put the chemistry code here, CHEX. Suppose I'll write chemistry and save. Now you will find there are two authorized bill has already been done, and likewise you can prepare the authorized bill according to your organization. Now I'll show you how those authorized values to the your mark field. To your mark field. So for that I'll go to Koha administration. I'll click on mark bibliographic structure. Mark bibliographic framework. That means I will edit the framework. So here the different frameworks are also been prepared. So I will edit this books framework. I'll click on this is the books framework. Remember, never edit the framework in a default. Books framework, mark structure. So now I want to add this to my mark structure. Now I'll search with 952. That is the item structure, item field. So now this is the 952. I will edit the subfields, and I will link that with any of the subfield. So now you will find that here different fields are there. You have to select any one field. Okay, you have to. So in my case, I have done this collection code. Collection code. But you can, if you want to take this any one, like Koha normalized value for section, then you can take anything where there is a nothing, no restriction or any field. Free field. Okay, then or you can prepare a new also. So in my case I have made collection code, and I have here the department has been changed. So you can take like current location, holding branch, where a sale being location. So different are there. If you find that you do not find anything, you can change anything from them, or you can add a new. You can add a new from here. So you better to take anyone which is related to you. Okay. So in my library, I have taken this one because I have changed the. Actually, I have changed the authorized below C code from there. I have changed the authorized below C code from there. Basically, here collection code I have given. So I will take from advanced country, authorized value is C code. I will make it department, and it's saved. Now you see the where these changes are taking place. Now I'm trying to edit a particular item. Trying to edit a particular item. Let me check whether I have any book already entered or not. I will check. Then I will edit a particular item. Okay. Edit items. Let's take this book, edit item, and you'll find where it is located actually. Now you will find that collection code is written physics and chemistry. As I have made a connection of collection code to the my authorized values, the collection code is coming here. So apparently you can change anywhere. You can change the shelving location also. These are the already shelving, you can change from here. So shelving control number. So these are the shelving control number. You can change the this, you can change this text also. If I change it in the shelving control number. Okay, so let me change that again. I'll go to administration. I'll go to administration, mark bibliographic framework, and books, edits, mark structure. I'll click on mark structure. I'll click on mark structure and 952. 952. Because in 952 only I'll link this. If you find that whatever you have done is not correct, you can change later, no problem. You go to edit whatever you have done and make it blank. Okay, now you change for a new item, new place. I will go for J, shelving control number. Authorized below stack is already there, so we'll the stack is not available at this moment. Now we'll control department from here. We'll link department from here and use. You can change this text for librarian. You can change this. Subject, you can change subject, save, now you refresh here, you will find it's available. Likewise, you can link you can prepare any authorized values and link to fields here, and you can edit whatever the authorized values available there, and you can add accordingly here. This will help in that is a addition creation of a local type of database, because authorized values are changed different from organization to organization, and you can do in bulk also. You can do the changes in bulk also, like in bulk modification also. In terms of I want to, this is 3128. I want to change bulk, because this I have done now. I already have around 1000 books, so this can be done in bulk also. You go to tools, batch item modification, so write 3128 and continue. It's coming. And in shelving control number you can change. The thing is that when you are doing in bulk, this format is coming from default. So in the default also you have to change the editing in terms of bulk. In terms of bulk you have to change the mark structure in default also, then only it will come here. Okay, so again then you can do it, either change it from here and put save accordingly. This will be showing here, this collection code has according to your choice. So this is all about creation of authorized values and linking to mark structure. Thank you. I hope this video will help you. Don't forget to share the NecoLib YouTube channel and subscribe also. Goodbye.